Hi everybody, David Dilling from Markzware here. Markzware has just released ID2Q version 6. ID2Q is InDesign to Quark and now has InDesign CS5.5 support. Furthermore, this extension for QuarkXPress now works in version 9.1, of course version 8 as well. Let's go check out the new features and functions in Markzware's ID2Q version 6.
Fantastic. Before I show you how ID2Q version 6 works, let's first take a look at an InDesign file inside InDesign. In a moment, we will convert this file right on over into Quark. To use ID2Q version 6 in Quark 9.1 or Quark 9 or Quark 8, and you go over here to the Markzware menu item and you choose ID2Q. We see the ID2Q here. You can convert an InDesign document. Just click there. In this window, you just go find where the document is you want to convert. In this case, it's the file we just showed you in InDesign, and hit open. It's pretty much that simple, but there are a few options. Conversion options. This is how it will come standard out of the box. Later, we'll go over some of the post-conversion fix options, for they can be handy if you're using complex tables or have other overflow text box issues, etc. So, out of the box, just click OK and see how easy and how fantastic the conversion is. You'll see ID2Q version 6 reading the document, similar to how Flight Check does when pre-flighting and packaging files from InDesign, Quark, Microsoft, etc. The conversion is quite fast, naturally for larger files, and if you have a lot of post-conversion fixing, it will take longer. There you go. All right, let's take a closer look at this InDesign file now within QuarkXPress 9.1, ready for us to edit, use, and publish either to the iPod or to print. All right, so you see the file looks fantastic, pretty much exactly as it did just a moment ago in InDesign. And we scroll down and we see all the text and styles and attributes came over, really looking good. Uh-oh, but wait a minute, what's going on here? Are there pictures missing? If we resize it a bit, what we'll see is that there are tables used, cells. Okay, so let's convert that file again. We'll select the same exact file, hit open. And this time, let's look at these conversion options a little more closely. So these will be post-conversion fix options that we can employ within ID2Q version 6. This is quite neat, and we've added several here, including overflow text boxes, link text boxes. We'll allow them to relink with the post-fix options. This table issue we just saw in action. Let's click auto-adjust tables and click OK and see how that affects our conversion at the end. Okay, here's the file again. Get down here to this page. Look at this. All of those cells, all those tables now come over. We don't have to resize them. They're already resized, or we should say, already the post-conversion fix has been done. So folks, this is ID2Q version 6 from Markzware. It'll convert your InDesign CS5.5, 5, CS4, CS3, CS2 files right into QuarkXPress 9.1, 9.0, etc. Hey everybody, just cruise over to www.markzware.com and you'll see all of the information on our products, including the new Flight Check 6.80 for total print quality control for prepress operators, graphic designers, publishers alike. Alright, to see ID2Q, to buy it today, just go to Products, ID2Q. We click on ID2Q, we'll see all information on this product. We can even read down here what other people are saying about ID2Q. Buy now to get ID2Q version 6. Very affordable, extremely easy to use to convert InDesign CS5.5 and lower files right into QuarkXPress 9.1 projects, where you can use them to create iPod content, print content, online content, it doesn't matter, it's all possible.
Thank you for watching this ID2Q version 6 demonstration. Once again, thank you. David Dilling from Markzware wishing you a fantastic day, and please go ahead and click that buy button on the Markzware homepage and get ID2Q today. Take care.